This is part of parasympathetic nervous system, and you know that parasympathetic system influence on the heart negatively. Yes, it inhibits its activity. Remember all effects? Negative. Enotropic effect, decrease the force of the contraction, decrease heart stroke volume. Negative. Chromotropic effect, decrease heart rate, decrease excitability, bathymotropic effect, dromotropic effect, conductivity, and tonotropic effect. All effects are negative, so this sensor can inhibit, decrease heart work, and decrease pressure, finally, yes? At the same time, we have pressure center. This cardio inhibitory center have some level of activity, basal level of activity, rather high, as well as pressor sensor. Both of them are rather active and they maintain heart work. This center through the nerve vagus, parasympathetic nervous system, this center through the sympathetic nervous system, yes? And you remember that in our lateral horns of spinal cord in thoracic segments, we have neurons which are responsible for the innervation of our heart. Yes? And this sympathetic nervous system will have positive effects on our heart. Positive means stimulative effect. It can increase heart work, contraction, the strength of the contraction, excitability, conductivity, tonicity of the heart. And if this center will be more active than this one, heart will work harder, yes, and that will increase pressure because stronger contraction and faster contraction increase pressure. Okay. In this system, we have also, in this center, we have depressor center. This center has no output. It is not connected with the sympathetic or parasympathetic nervous system. It can influence on the pressor center, as well as the pressor center can influence on the depressor center. They have reciprocal interaction. Reciprocal means when one center is active, this one is inactive. If this center is activated, it can inhibit pressor center. So if this pressor center sends a lot of impulses to the heart, you remember also that pressor center can activate sympathetic nervous system, which innervates our vessels. Yes? And how sympathetic nervous system influence on the vessels? Mostly it causes constriction. There are three types of neurons, postganglionic neurons, noradrenergic, they produce constriction. Acetylcholinergic, they work mostly in skeletal muscles and they cause vasorelaxation. And there is yet one type, noradrenergic, noradrenergic sympathetic neurons, which release peptides, different types of peptides or nitric oxide, and their effect can be different, relaxation or contraction. It depends on the type of mediator which is released here in this end of this neurons. So generally, activation of sympathetic nervous system causes constriction, smaller diameter, higher pressure. You see, smaller diameter, higher pressure. So sympathetic nervous system, activation of sympathetic nervous system increases pressure because of it can increase, stimulate heart work, strength of the contraction and frequency of the contraction, and it can cause vasoconstriction, decrease radius of the vessel, increase total peripheral resistance, and increase pressure. So, when pressure is very high, imagine that this center is too strongly activated and pressure becomes higher than normal, 100 to 120, systolic and diastolic increase. How this center will get information that pressure is too high? It's necessary to make feedback, yes?
And there are special types of receptors. Where are they situated? Okay, in our vessels, in arterial aorta, in
paralyteus, in vena cava, in carotid sinuses, yes, there are special receptors, baroreceptors, which can react on the increasement of pressure. If pressure is normal or lower, they cannot be excited, cannot be stimulated. Only higher pressure, higher than 140, will increase frequency of impulses from these receptors, and this information will go to the depressor center. And this information will activate depressor center, and this center will inhibit depressor center. This center is inhibited, cardioinhibitory center still is active, it will decrease work of the heart. There is no more activating stimulus from sympathetic nervous system. Pressure will
decrease.
If pressure decreases, this receptors cannot send more impulses to the center. Pressure center again becomes active because it has some tonicity. There are some neural pacemakers here, and they can stimulate again heart and vessels to a little bit increase. There is yet one type of stimulus which can regulate heart work and vessels to maintain normal blood pressure. This is a chemical stimulus. Because imagine if pressure is too low, blood flow is also not so fast, is rather low. If blood flows slowly through the tissues, it accumulates carbon dioxide, it releases all oxygen, and in this blood we have very low level of oxygen. Such condition we call hypoxia. Accumulation of CO2 leads to hypercapnia. And the acidity also is increased because accumulation of acidic products, metabolites. And this chemical stimulus from our vessels, from our blood, they can activate chemoreceptors from the same reflexogenic zones. We have it different proportion of these receptors in different parts of reflexogenic zones. For example, in our venous part of circulatory system, we have more chemoreceptors than baroreceptors. Most of the baroreceptors we have in aorta, in carotid sinus. And this information from chemoreceptors is delivered to the pressor center. Low PO2, higher PCO2, partial pressure of carbon dioxide, lower pH. All these chemical stimulus can activate pressor center, stimulate heart contraction, heart work, increase tonicity of the vessels to increase blood pressure. Then higher will be pressure, then faster blood will flow through the circulatory system, and here in pulmonary circulation it will remove excessive amount of CO2, will be saturated with enough amount of oxygen, yes, and this blood will be more useful for our tissues, yes. So heart and vessels will work in such direction to increase blood pressure, to increase flow of blood through the circulation, to saturate blood with the oxygen, and to remove CO2. In such way, this pressor center can be activated by this chemical stimulus. Of course, the same stimulus will influence on our respiratory center. Here in medulla oblongata, we have very close to hemodynamic center, we have respiratory center. And both these stimulus can cause activation of respiration and circulation. Because if we will breathe with the same rate, but our circulation will be fast, it will be difficult to saturate blood with oxygen, yes? We need to start to breathe faster, deeper and faster, and to maintain higher level of circulation with a higher speed. In this way, it will be possible to restore normal level of PCO2, PO2, and pH. during respiratory physiology, where again we'll discuss how transfer of oxygen is maintained by coordination of two systems, respiratory system and cardiovascular system. Here I will I just told you a few preliminary information.
Okay, but is it clear? So this hemodynamic center, is situated in the medulla oblongata. But another part of our brain, like hypothalamus, what else? Limbic system, cortex, they can influence on the medulla oblongata and regulate activity of this center according our emotional status, according to our vegetative functions, different vegetative functions like temperature, for example, or pain, or our cortex knows about movement of our body. If our muscle, they need more oxygen, more nutrients, this upper parts of the brain will influence on the medulla oblongata and will stimulate our cardiovascular system to deliver enough oxygen and nutrients. This is about regulation, and in your book there is a question about pressor and depressor reflexes. Depressor reflexes starts from the baroreceptors. They activate depressor center, and this depressor center will inhibit depressor center and leads to the decreasement of pressure. From chemical stimulus, from chemoreceptors, we can activate pressor center and increase pressure because of stimulation of heart and vessels, cause constriction of the vessel and leads to increasement of blood pressure. So we can